The topic of this present module is circulation management and control in spatial and research libraries. The objectives of this module are to understand various circulation activities, functions, services of circulation section in spatial and technical libraries, to study the factors involved in planning circulation process, to find out duties and responsibilities of library personnel in circulation section of spatial and technical libraries, to study various charging methods, to understand automated circulation system. It introduces that the primary function of the library is to make proper use of resources available in it. Because of growing needs of various types of readers, it became essential to arrange books systematically on the shelves so that it becomes easier to search books and other reading material. An ideal charging system should therefore have the following capabilities, that is, it should be able to identify the books that are charged, to detect the borrower to whom a particular book is issued, to find out when the book is to be received back in the library, to measure the extent of use of books, and to indicate the number of books circulated per day. The circulation section involves following functions, that is, registration of members, renewal and withdrawal membership, lending of books, which includes charging and discharging work of its members, renewal of books, reservation of books, recall, that is, issue reminders for overdue books, issue reminders for overdue books, then charging of overdues, maintenance of records and statistics, interlibrary loan, maintenance of gate register and property counter, and miscellaneous jobs. The first and the foremost function of a well-equipped library is to lend reading material to its readers so that they are able to read them in their convenient places. The books are lent out only to those who have registered themselves as a member of a library. In case of special and research libraries, the membership is exclusively met for its scientists. In case of public and academic libraries, membership fee and library security, which is refundable at the time of termination of membership, is charged from its members. But in case of special and research libraries, this library service is free of cost to its members. The purpose of registration involves the following. Firstly, to know about the complete address of a borrower who has borrowed library material. Then registration of files providing the information regarding the standing strength of the library. Registration enables the user to make use of privileges of the library. For registration of membership, special and research library has a prescribed form for membership which is to be filled up by the borrower. The application form may be of 5x3 inches in size, and the registration is usually done for a definite period, and borrower's card are used to the borrower. The following slide shows the specimen of membership form, its recto and verso. Then the lending of books, registration enables the members of the library to take advantage of the privileges of the library. The charging procedure involves the following. User takes out the book from the shelves and takes them to the issue counter for getting them issued in his name. The assistant, after verifying the bona fides of the member, makes necessary reports in accordance with the specific charging system followed in the particular library. The counter assistant takes out the book card out of the book pocket and keeps the reader's ticket and book cards in juxtaposition in the charging tray. The book cards contain the call numbers and accession number of the book along with the other required information about the book. The membership cards and the membership cum identity card is generally returned to the member along with the books. After reading the books, comes back to the library for returning the books. He presents the books as a return counter of the library in such a manner that due date slip pasted in the book is visible. The counter assistant examines the books to ascertain whether the book is in sound condition or not. He also ascertains due date, date of issue after from due date slip to find out whether the book is returned in time or not. If it is overdue, then overdue fine is calculated and received from the borrower. The membership ticket card is returned to the member. Date slip locates the corresponding card from the charging tray by looking up the cards behind the relevant date guide. The call number or accession number is looked up and the corresponding card are traced out from behind the particular date guide. The book cards along with the reader's ticket, membership cards are taken out of the charging tray and the book cards are slipped into the book pockets and the membership tickets are handed over to the members. Then reservation of books. Due to general awakening and increased emphasis on research, the demand for current documents has increased tremendously. Sometimes there are certain documents which remain in great demand, but due to stringency of funds, the special libraries are incapable of meeting all the demands of the readers. Due to this reason, an adequate number of copies of certain documents cannot be purchased. When readers or members find some difficulty in getting particular books in a library, they are directed by the librarian to get such books reserved. In reservation procedure, the reader in need of particular book gives in writing the particulars of the book along his address, or he fills up a printed card and hands over the same to the counter assistant. This reservation card is generally self-addressed and self-stamped so that the intimation may be sent to the concerned reader whenever the book is available in the library. The present slide shows the specimen of reservation card, its recto and verso side. Then the reservation slip. Then renewal procedure. Renewals represent an extension of loan period by recharging the same item to the same borrower. Books may be renewed by presenting the book in person or by post or by telephone depending on the library policy. However, renewal is allowed on condition that book will be returned immediately if recalled. Recall is an important controlling activity concerned with circulation. The activity of calling books back into the library so that they can be lent to the other person is known as recalls. Then issue of reminders for overdue books. Sending regular reminders for an overdue books is one of the most important activities of counter assistant. Then charging of overdue. An overdue charge is traditionally lived with those books which are returned after due date by the borrowers. Maintenance of records and statistics. The maintenance of records in circulation department is very important because these records form the basis of collecting statistics on documents taken on loan. These statistics are invaluable in providing useful indicators to the library to plan its acquisition policy, nature of service, the range and type of users, etc. Interlibrary loan. As no library is self-sufficient due to limited funds, therefore they need to depend on other cooperating libraries in the city or region to obtain books and other library materials required by the readers. Such loans between libraries are known as interlibrary loan. The maintenance of gate register and property counter. As circulation is usually located close to the entrance gate or exit gate, the circulation department is entrusted with the task of maintaining the gate register and property counter. Then gate register, a record of daily visitors and purpose of visit to the library is maintained in the form of a gate register. Property counter, as users are not allowed to bring books and other material and other belongings inside the library, a property counter is usually installed near the entrance of the library. Then then the responsibilities of library personnel of circulation section. The present chart is depicting the various responsibilities of professional, semi-professional and non-professional staff. The professional staff is charged with the duties of registration of readers, then lending of books, control processes like renewals, recall, hold, overdues and notifications, management and organization of book exhibitions, then render assistance to stacks verification, help readers in finding required material for study. The semi-professional staff is charged with the charging and discharging of reading material needed by the borrowers, reservation of books, renewal service and overdues, then maintenance of issue records, maintenance of registration records, maintenance of records of loans, keep a file of registered borrowers, keep up to date statistics relating to books and other functions. Then the non-professional staff is charged with the shelving and stacking of reading material, reshelving of reading material after they are consulted by the readers, maintenance of gate and readers visiting register, have effective non-stop control and vigilance over the entrance and exit gate during the working hours, property counter service, then membership card service, dusting and cleaning of stack material after regular intervals of time. Then the charging methods. Several charging and discharging systems available for adoption in libraries are register system like daybook system, ledger system, then card system like Brownie charging system, New York charging system, then deteriorate self charging system, machine charging system like Dickman's charging system, Gaylord charging system, photocopying charging system, audio charging system and computer based charging system. Then this is the specimen of materials required by the Brownie charging system. The specimen of book pocket is given here. The size of the book pocket is 12.7 into 7.6 centimeters. And the specimen of book card, it is 10.25 centimeters into 5 centimeters. Then the specimen of date slip and the specimen of borrower's ticket is also shown in this slide. The slide shows the ownership slip, book pocket, then book card, date slip pasted on fly leaf of the book, and the book card is also shown in the slide. Then Brownie charging system procedure. Charging is the issue of books that are presented at the circulation counter to the borrowers. In this routine, book to be borrowed and the borrower's ticket are presented by the user to the issue counter assistant at circulation desk counter. The issue counter assistant, after the identification of the borrower, takes out the book card from the book pocket and slips it into the borrower's ticket or pocket in the juxtaposition are filed in the charging tray behind the respective due date card by call number. The due dates are stamped on the due date slip and the charged book is handed over to the user. The call number and borrower number are recorded in the daily circulation statistics sheet. In the Brownie charging system procedure, the discharging is the work of securing books borrowed and releasing the borrower's ticket. This routine will involve the following. When a book is returned by the borrower at counter, the issue return counter assistant locates the charged reader's ticket in the charging tray. Book card coupled with the reader's ticket is picked up from behind the appropriate date guide card from charging tray. The due date issue date is cancelled on the due date slip and reader's ticket is returned to the reader. The book card is inserted into the book pocket and the book is thus duly discharged and reader is absolved of his responsibility. If the book is returned after the due date, due overdue amount is calculated and overdue charge slip is given. The advantages of Brownie charging system, since only the stamp is put on the date slip, therefore the promptness is in issuing books is ensured. The issue of reminders and calculation of fines overdue is simplified. The statistics of issue can be prepared easily without any loss of time. Reserves and recalls can be carried out promptly. This system saves the time of the staff and reader to a great extent. The disadvantages of Brownie charging system are that no permanent record of issue is available and there is always danger of loss of books. It is not possible to ascertain the number of books issued to a person as borrower's tickets are scattered. It cannot be easily ascertained as to with whom particular book is issued and when is due. In case of loss of ticket, misuse is possible as the signature of the reader is not necessary. This system occupies lots of space for keeping the issue records. The charging trays remain full of capacity. However, despite of these limitations, this system is very popular because of its simplicity in the procedure. Then the slide shows the various material pointing out charging system. New York charging procedure involves the following steps. The borrower presents the book to the borrower along with the borrower's card to the counter assistant at circulation counter. The counter assistant removes the book card from the book pocket. The due date or date of issue, whichever is used, is stamped on the date slip in the book by the counter assistant. Similarly, the due date is stamped on the book card taken out of the book pocket and borrower's card. The signatures of the borrowers is obtained. The borrower's number is written opposite the date in the book card and filed behind the concerned date guide card in the charging tray. The borrower's card and the books are returned to the user, thus the book is duly charged. At the end of the day, the book cards are sorted out and are arranged by the call numbers behind the due date or due date slip. Advantages of New York charging system. There is a permanent record of number and types of books circulated and kind of books borrowed by each borrower. It is possible to know at all times where the given book is and to whom it is charged and when it is due. The record of the number of times a book has been circulated is available even when the book is not in the library, since the transaction is recorded both in the borrower's card as well as on the book cards, the danger of dislocation is minimal. If the borrower's card are lost, the record on the book cards is available and vice versa. Several assistants can perform the work on the routines simultaneously. The borrowers can be allowed to borrow books from any branch of the library or larger library system, provided there is a central registration file at the main library where an alphabetical arranged copy of all branches registrations is available. Various disadvantages of New York charging system are that the charging routines are slow, time consuming and cumbersome. The procedure of writing, stamping of the date of issue, due date and borrower's membership number on the book cards and writing, stamping of issue, due date on the borrower's card are time consuming. Inaccuracies can occur while entering the borrower's number, accession number and call number in the book card. This is particularly true during rush hours. Two registration files need to be maintained, one in an alphabetical file by the borrower's name and addresses, and the other is a file of registration numbers assigned to each borrower. Library rules can be misused as there is a way of controlling mechanically the number of books to be issued to each borrower. In spite of several disadvantages, the New York system is considered in the libraries. Then, automated circulation system. Circulation of documents is one of the most important housekeeping operations of a library. The automation of circulation function of a library is one of the most difficult tasks This is because of complications involved in the procedure. The circulation procedure is in a conventional system is very lengthy and consumes much of the time in repetitive works. The use of technological devices such as computers, scanners, radio frequency identification, detection, that is RFID technology, etc., helps in the performance of routine circulation operations easily and quickly. It saves lots of time of the staff as well as users. It helps the library staff in charging and discharging of documents, reservation of documents, sending reminders to the borrowers of the books, collection of overdues, interlibrary loan, and maintenance of various records very quickly and efficiently. RFID is the latest technology to make strong security and automatic identification surveillance system in the libraries. If the material that has not been properly checked out, then at the time of access, an alarm is triggered. An RFID system for a library contains 8 components, that is RFID tags, a shelf checkout station, a staff checkout station, self return book drop with an automatic check-in feature, a tagging station, a set of security gates, and a shelf scanner. The self-checkout station allows library members to borrow books without the help of library staff. Book drop allows returning of books and updating the database. Shelving station speeds up the process of sorting return of books for pre-shelving. Now, from the detailed discussion, it is summarized that special and research librarian's job is to provide books and other kinds of material to the client. For smooth functioning of any special library, circulation section is concerned with various activities such as registration of members, renewal and withdrawal of membership, lending of books, that is charging and discharging work to its members, renewal of books, then reservation of books, recall, that is issue reminders of overdue books, charging of overdues, maintenance of records and statistics, interlibrary loan, maintenance of gate register and property counter. In order to give borrowers excellent service, librarians have to use efficient and economical charging system. An ideal charging system should be able to identify the books that are charged, that is, be able to ascertain whether a book is in the library or is issued, detect the borrower to whom a particular book is issued, and be able to find out when the book is to be received back in the library. The circulation desk is considered to be the hub center of all activities of special library, and popularity and prestige of the library is measured by the service rendered by the circulation staff. The circulation section must be able to inform the readers as to with whom the particular document is at a particular moment. This can be ensured by the maintenance of proper and foolproof circulation record. The circulation staff should, in order to fulfill the aims of the library in general and those of the circulation department in particular, cooperate with the other departments of the library. In other words, it must gather and pass on requisite information to the readers and the staff at right time more efficiently. Thus, circulation service in special and research libraries is the basic function of the library.